What kind of illumination and how much do you need to make a hyperspectral imaging application? We know that you need much, much more than when using RGB camera or black and white camera. In the visible wavelength range, LEDs are already an option to halogen light, but in the near infrared region, you need halogen lamp, although LEDs are soon a viable option. But when you are using halogen lamp, how much do you need to illuminate your sample and get reasonable results? I have a simple rule of thumb, so let's look at that.
So this is a very common question. What is the illumination power needed for FX17 in the near infrared region? In practice, this is a very difficult question, and in most cases, I make tests for this. But I made a very simple rule of thumb that gives the approximate power needed. And the equation is actually simple. We have power is a constant times r squared divided by integration time. So in this, the constant is 10 watt second divided by square meter, and the t is integration time that is used, and r is the distance from illumination line to the target. And to explain this a little bit more, I have two examples. First, we assume that the distance from the illumination to surface is something like 25 centimeters, and the integration time is 0.01 second. Simply calculating based on this, we get that the power needed is 60 watts. And of course, when we are illuminating a line, we should divide this power so that the whole line, 20 to 30 centimeters, is covered evenly. And we can get that one can achieve this illumination by using six halogen lamps with the power of 10 watts each, maybe 15 or 20 watts each, in 2 × 45° configuration. And in practice, this is what we have in the 20 to 40 scanners, where the illumination is about 30 centimeters in width and made of three halogen lamps, and actually six halogen lamps in 2 × 45° assembly. Now, my next example is a little bit bigger system, where we have a distance from the illumination to the surface about 50 centimeters, and our integration time is 5 milliseconds. Again, putting this to the equation, we get that the power needed is 500 watts, which is actually close to 10 times more. And doubling the distance from the light source to surface and only reducing the integration to half increases the need for illumination really, really quickly. And this actually is the case when we are looking at the bigger systems, where the line width is something like 70 centimeters up to 1 meter. And the lessons we learn from this is that as the illumination should actually be as close as possible to the sample surface, and one should use as long integration time as possible. Of course, this is a compromise between sample resolution, speed of conveyor belt, and so on. But to reduce the need for illumination, we should think about the distance of our light source or to the surface that we need to measure.